And let's see what will happen to us in the paradise of Allah.
In Jannah, in the paradise, mada aynu ra'at. There is no such eyes can even see something like the Jannah. Wala udun sami'at. Not even ears, you cannot even hear about the true Jannah, because the Jannah is beyond what you are hearing. Wala khatara ala qalbi bashar. You cannot even imagine, you cannot even describe or think what is the Jannah. Before, let me describe something beautiful about your castle. Your castle in the Jannah is something so beautiful.
So beautiful.
Your castle in the Jannah has four doors.
Four doors.
You enter from one door. And one door or one gate, your servants from all kind of servants would come and enter to help you. You have 70,000 servants 70, in the paradise, in that castle. 70,000 in that paradise. Imagine this.
Imagine.
And one door, there's one door you enter, one door your servants, and one door there is a special angel who come to you every Friday.
Every Friday.
Every Friday, they come and they visit you on the Friday, have a small card in his hand.
That
angel has a beautiful small card in his hand. And guess what is written in the card?
Oh, come on, not that one.
It is a message from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Message from Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Abdi. In that card. Abdi will be my servant. In another riwayah called it Tirmidhi, Abdana. This is my honored servant. Ishtaqtu ilayka. I miss you.
I miss you.
And I need you. And I miss you.
Fazurni. And so come and visit me. Allah send you this.
The creator of the heavens and earth.
Guys, Allah Himself will send every Muslim, every Abdul in the top of this earth a card. The card says, I miss you, visit me. And this is every Friday. Every Friday there's a door, this door only for that angel. The angel will come from that door and he have a card in his hand. You open the card, it says, my slave, I miss you, visit me. And look how happy he is. Allahu Akbar, brother.
Allahu Akbar.
Imagine,
Allahu
yes,
Akbar.
Allah Himself will
Allahu
send you a card. Okay.
He's calling. Imagine the creator of the earth, the one he creates, you create everything. He said, come and visit me.
We get excited if, say, the president was saying, hey, look, I want to have a meeting with you.
Unbelievable.
Imagine Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala Himself sending this message with a small card. My servant is stuck to it. I miss you. Come and visit me. The fourth door, you will go out from your castle to visit the present of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The moment you put your right foot outside the house, there is a rain of musk, a beautiful perfume, will cover you.
Wow.
Until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prepare around the throne, in the throne subhanahu wa ta'ala, karasi, chairs, front of the...
What is that, man? What is that? Are you watching, Muslims? Chairs, four doors, 70,000 slaves in your house to serve you, 70,000 slaves. Allah having chairs around him, and you will sit around Allah with the chairs. And then if you listen to the story, you will see it's a party time. Allah, he will ask David to read from his book, singing, and the birds will be singing with him. And then he asked the Muslims, do you ever hear better than this? They said, no, Allah. Then he asked Muhammad to sing. Then Muhammad, he sing, and the Muslims go crazy. They say to them, did you ever see better than this? They say, no, Allah. Now, isn't it boring? Every Friday, this is what will happen. David, he will sing the same song. And then Muhammad will sing the same song. And then everybody say, Allahu Akbar, we never heard this before. This is heaven. Every Friday, we will go there and we will listen to the same guy. He will say the same thing. And he asked us, did you ever hear better than this? We say, no, Allah, Allahu Akbar, no. Party time, party time. Are you enjoying, Abdul? Abdul, are you enjoying the party?
Ashribun, give given to drink. This is for a drink. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, listen to this. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will tell Dawood alayhi salam. Dawood, David alayhi salam, stir up my servant David, Dawood. Recite to them a Zabur, the son of David alayhi salam.
The Psalms
to be recited by David alayhi salam.
David the prophet David.
David prophet David alayhi salam.
I love this song.
And imagine when David alayhi salam reciting, the birds would be like reciting after him. The river would stop. Imagine this. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling those people.
The rivers will stop. Like the river, he would say to the water, listen, stop. Do you hear this? Stop. Rivers, stop. The rivers will stop. You see, Muhammad, he knew everything would happen in heaven. And this is all, is not in the Quran. From where Muhammad he got this information, we don't know. And you know what? How stupid this scenario is. Like, what is the beauty about something? I know exactly every word will be said. Everything will happen step by step, even if somebody fought. Like, you know what? I will be upset if somebody start telling me about the movie before I watch it. I said to him, guy, come on, listen, don't do that. Let me enjoy the movie. Don't burn it for me, correct? He's telling them everything will happen, and everything will happen is very boring. Like, so what if David is singing? And?
People, my servant, have you ever heard the beautiful more than that? And this is, وَعِزَّتَكَ وَجَلَالَكَ by your glory and your power, Ya Allah. We never heard beautiful more than that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
This is mean the Quran is not beauty more than what David will read. This means the Quran say lies that Quran is the most beautiful recitation or book. This means the Muslims themselves, Muhammad, they are a bunch of liars when they say the Quran is the most beautiful. He will go, the Muslim themselves, they will hear David not reading Quran. And David will be reading the Psalms? Okay, great. So Muslims who was Muslims all their life, who heard Quran, they will say, we never heard better than this. And then the second singer will stand up. Who is the second singer? Guess what? It's not Michael Jackson.
He's in front of you. Now, he's reciting to you Surah Taha.
Muhammad.
Allah Azza wa Jalla will tell you and tell all of us, my servant, ya ibadi, هل سمعتم أفضل من ذلك? Have you ever heard? سمعنكم أفضل من ذلك. I will make you hear more beautiful more than that. Listen, Allah Azza wa Jalla telling Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, stand up Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, recite to them Surah Taha. How much we love the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. How much we follow the steps of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. How much we dream about him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. How much we read about him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Now he's in front of you.
Each time he say Muhammad, he says, Allah praise him. No, Allah praise him and salute him, not only praise him. The translated they say in English, peace upon him. The fact in Arabic doesn't say that. It says, Allah praise him or pray on him and salute him. Now Muhammad will stand and sing for you. And he will ask them, did you hear most beautiful than this? They will say, absolutely no, Allah. And this is very boring. This is heaven. Every Friday, I will be listening to David and Muhammad singing. Muhammad, he will read the chapter Taha in the Quran. David, he will read it from the book, supposedly his book. The same verses, every Friday. What a boring heaven. What is that? This is the party now? This is the best Allah can do? He got only these singers for us, nobody dancer? I thought we would have better entertainment. Let us move with the video, see something else.
Every person will know his house. You don't need a GPS, you don't need a picture. We have, as I said, 70,000 servants will just helping you. The moment you enter the Jannah, by the way, there is a group of angels. They were telling you, Salamun alaykum, kutitum fadukhuluha. Salamun alaykum. They will tell you, Salamun alaykum.
Man, the angels will sing for you. Salamun alaykum biyutakum fadkhuluha, and peace unto you, dear, how your houses, go into it as well.
That's mean good job. Well done.
So they'll be wishing the peace on you.
Absolutely. From the beginning, you enter the Jannah. And there is a peace be upon you. Say salamun alaykum. You did a good job. Tubtum fadkhuluha.
Kind of like, good job, good work.
Yeah, because you really work hard to reach that place.
Yeah.
And you will enter the Jannah, and imagine every person will know his house. You don't need a GPS, you don't need a map, you don't need anything. The angels will take your servants, will take you to your place in the Jannah. And imagine with me here, the moment you enter with your right foot, you will find your couches.
Couches.
And you lay down. What are you going to see, you think?
What do you think?
You're going to see the ceiling of your...
Just wait, guys. Let me see how good you are. What we will see when you are laying down in your couch? Who want to tell me? What we will see when you are laying down in your couch? Anyone knows? When you lay down in your couch, what we will see? No. You will see the butt of Allah. Because simply your house is under the chair of Allah. Allah butt in the top of you. You are living under his butt. Listen.
Place, if your place in the Jannah, your castle, it is the throne of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Part of the throne of Allah, and you look at the, how beautiful is that? And you're relaxing, and your servants around you, and that is from, and it's the bricks. The bricks, one brick of gold and one brick of silver. One gold, one silver. And saffron, and rubies, and diamond. It's the
diamond?
Throne. Imagine this. And the cups. Cup of silver, cup of gold, and you have everything, the jewel, things you cannot even imagine. We cannot even describe. That's what we read in the Quran, we read in the Sunnah. But in reality,
guys, did he say anything about the black stones in heaven? He said rubies, he said jewelries, he said gold, he said silver, the floor from the rubies, from diamonds, right? But did he say any black stones? No. It's not exist there.
Is more beautiful more than that. You things you cannot even imagine. I'm telling you. Whatever I describe, you know, for example, you eat in the Jannah. There is a password.
Mm-hmm.
In the Jannah, there is a password. What is that password?
Password.
What is it? Yeah. Subhanallah.
Password.
Subhanallah.
Subhanallah.
To God. That's it. For example, what is that password? You see in the tub a bird, a beautiful bird. You wish, only you wish, that bird is for you. That bird, it have like a roasted bird. He says, Subhanallah, you have it. He says, Alhamdulillah. So,
this is a password everybody know now. It's a password. You say, Subhanallah, you look at the bird, you say, Subhanallah, he will be between your hands. If you see the wife of your friend, you say, Subhanallah, she will be in your lap. You know, you see that, what is that, man? What is this fantasy? You know, Muslims, do you have a brain? Any Muslim, for God's sake, you have a brain? What's up? Muslims, like, come on, man. And if Allah will give you all the food you want, everything you want, you have 70,000 servant, and then you see a bird in the fly, in the fly, and you say, I wish to have him, he will be between your hands. This is the password.